Right? So it's very hard for the chief planning officer, the CEO, and his or her team to say, gee, we kind of think option A is the right way to approach the market, but you know what? We're going to bet 30% of our resources on B. A population of startups, you have independent minds, each pursuing their own vision, their own passion, their own view of the way the future of this technology, this market's going to work. So collectively, they are covering A, B, or C. So I think fundamentally, if the established firm is to really engage in parallelism, it needs to create kind of discrete resource allocation centers and bases within it. And essentially, you know, metaphorically, that's necessary to become of, quote, multiple minds. In the absence of that, what I find, what you see, I think, is latent experiments are happening, but they're ultimately squashed through a kind of singular selection criteria, singular mindset that the dominant executive team has in that enterprises.
Can you give an example?
Blackberry is very successful at one juncture in a highly competitive market. So one can't take success for granted. It's tremendous pressure to come up with the next iteration of the Blackberry phone and that equipment. So the immediate reinforcers are towards refining the existing business model. But in the backdrop, why that energy is happening, there's a fundamental change to the phone as essentially a small computer, where apps are really critical. So the key application for BlackBerry, yes, it's a phone, and you add secure email. The world evolves, and all of a sudden, the phone is also this basis to entry point to the broader web. And the firm struggles with that, in some sense, kind of, again, is vectorized around its current approach. And really, I think there was sort of a business model cognitive failure to recognize what is a fundamental value added of BlackBerry. So it wasn't as if the managers weren't competitively engaged, but they were very much focused on the current context and their current ways of competing. I think for me, one of the interesting puzzles about the large established firms, such as whether it's Nokia or the RIM, is at one level, the large established firm can do experimentation. It has the resources, it can run parallel experiments vis-a-vis a startup, right? So if we think about the startup enterprise, there's lots of discussion about the lean startup. And the idea is, okay, you're going to engage in the market with these early prototypes, you'll get this feedback, and if the feedback is suggests maybe this isn't the right quite conception of market and technology, one pivots both in technical space and market space. The startup can really only run one experiment. So it's very responsive with that single initiative, and it needs to make that work very quickly, otherwise its funds run out and it's not going to make it. The established firm actually has the luxury of engaging in some level of parallelism. So I think my sense is the problem, the pathology for the established firm isn't you can't run parallel ways of competing, but fundamentally, if you're a hierarchical organization, the resource allocation is done by some central body. So while you can do many things, it's hard to be of multiple minds. I mean, that is this tension between exploiting, sort of essentially surviving in the moment, earning revenues in the moment, and exploring, finding new competitive opportunities, responding to a changing environment. So how does the enterprise to reconcile those two competing tensions.